magnetism. So magnetism, sort of like electric charge, produces an invisible force, and these kinds of invisible forces are popular for special effects, especially in science fiction. Now, with regards to magnets, a few basic observations. Most metals cannot be magnetized, so things like aluminum, copper, and such, you can't make a permanent magnet out of these metals. However, iron and a few other metals and some alloys are said to be ferromagnetic, which means they can be magnetized and remain magnetized. Now, magnets attract ferromagnetic metals, so not every piece of iron is magnetized, but a magnet will attract a piece of iron whether it's magnetized or not. Two magnets can either attract or repel each other depending on the poles of the magnet, and magnets have a north pole and a south pole, and if we have a south pole on one magnet and a north pole on another magnet, those two will attract. So these opposites attract, much like electric charge. And if we have a south pole next to another south pole, those two repel. Similarly, with a north pole repels another north pole. As I mentioned, not every metal is ferromagnetic. So here's a stack of coins. The ones on the left are not ferromagnetic, and the ones on the right are. Most of the ones that are ferromagnetic there simply have some iron or steel. Now, what happens with a piece of iron becoming magnetized is, first, if it's unmagnetized, then there are in the solid iron magnetic domains which are pointing in all random directions. So there's no synchronization or alignment of these magnetic domains. Each magnetic domain is like a tiny internal magnet. Well, if we bring a strong magnet close to that piece of iron that was unmagnetized, some of the internal domains start to become aligned with that strong magnet nearby, and then that piece of iron becomes weakly magnetized. Now, if we bring the strong magnet even closer and leave it there for a long time, then more and more magnetic domains become aligned, and eventually we have now a new piece of iron that has been magnetized. So we can see this in this demonstration. So I have a strong horseshoe magnet, and I've put a nail on it. Now that nail is magnetized, and you can see that it magnetizes the nail below it and the one below that. But now if I take it away, it returns to being unmagnetized. So, as I said, the magnetic domains and the iron nails are aligned by proximity to the strong magnet, so that each nail becomes a magnet temporarily. And when I remove the top nail from the strong horseshoe magnet, the domains return to being unaligned, and the nails lose most of their magnetization. Now, if I left those nails attached to the strong magnet, say overnight, then they would actually retain a permanent alignment and magnetization. Now, it's also possible to scramble those magnetic domains, and the easiest way to do that is by raising the temperature, which produces a lot of random molecular motion, and that will demagnetize a piece of iron. So here you see a nail which is hanging, and it is attracted to the horseshoe magnet. Now I'm gonna heat up the nail. So the nail is going to get red hot. And if I get it hot enough, see, once I get it hot enough, I have scrambled those magnetic domains inside the nail, and it can't retain alignment, and so it's no longer attracted to the horseshoe magnet. A simpler way of creating a magnet is to make an electromagnet. So when we have a current passing through a wire, there's a magnetic field that's produced, and we can augment that magnetic field by wrapping the wire into a coil, and then this current, when it passes through this coil of wire, produces a fairly strong magnet. We can make it even stronger by putting a piece of iron or steel inside of the coil. Here's an example of that. I have an electric coil. A coil is just wire wrapped many times around in a circle. So now I'm turning on the electromagnet. Now I'm turning it off. So electromagnets are also popular for special effects, like it's a plot element in this episode of Breaking Bad, where they install a large electromagnet in a truck in order to destroy some computers. Now, we know that the Earth has a magnetic field. If we have a small magnet on a pivot, that's a compass, and the magnet aligns with the Earth's magnetic field, being attracted to it. And since there is iron inside of the Earth's core, you might think that it was a permanent magnet, like the horseshoe magnet, but actually it's an electromagnet. And there's electric currents within the core of the Earth. We know it's not a permanent magnet because, as we saw, when iron gets hot, it can't retain the alignment, and it's extremely hot in the core of the Earth. Now, one last example of electromagnets is an electric motor. So we can have the force of an electromagnet serve to create a rotation by passing a current through some electromagnets with the appropriate orientations. So I'm going to turn on this simple motor, and I'll explain the operation here in a moment, but let's just watch it. Notice that there's a switch at the top of the motor, and as I'm increasing the current, the motor is spinning faster and faster. So the way this simple motor works is, at one point the central electromagnets are set up so that the North Pole is next to the North Pole on one side, and there's a South Pole next to the South Pole on the other side, and so of course they repel each other and the central shaft turns. Now, when this orange electromagnet, which starts out on the left, when it spins and it's over on the right, the switch at the top reverses the direction of the current, and that reverses the polarity of the electromagnet, and now this becomes a south, and so once again it is repelled, and so we continue the cycle back and forth as it spins around. So, in summary, most metals cannot be magnetized. Ferromagnetic metals, such as iron, can be magnetized by a magnetic field. Opposite poles, north and south, of magnets attract. Like poles, north and north, or south and south, repel. Magnetism may be removed by heating. Electric currents produce magnetic fields, like we saw in the electromagnet. The Earth's core acts as an electromagnet. And again, we know that it's not a permanent magnet because it's so hot. And finally, one example of an electromagnet is an electric motor, which uses electromagnets to create a force, and that force serves to produce the torque that turns the motor. So that's basics of magnetism. And you see from this last part, there's a strong connection between magnets and electric currents, and there's more to say about that, and we'll do that in the next tutorial.